Hello, my name is Simona Venuti. I'm a member of Guard Cybersecurity Team. The scope of this lesson is to understand the importance of risk management inside an organization. We will get some tips to evaluate the risk, some tips to manage the risk, some tips to handle incidents. The risk analysis procedure is important in order to mitigate the attacks and preserve ICT infrastructure, identify the security requirements, reducing the impact of security incidents. This is the risk management life cycle. We will see each item in detail. Risk identification. The school identifies and documents all its assets. We should make a documented inventory of people, who is doing what, data, what are the important data we want to preserve and protect, infrastructure, the objects, both hardware and software, used inside the organization. Then we have to identify and document the threats, that is, the menaces that could hit our asset, and the vulnerabilities, the weak points of our asset. This is a schema of a risk analysis. It could seem a nightmare, but actually it's not. For each item in the asset, we have to make a matrix that correlates the severity of the impact of the fault inside our organization and the probability of the fault to happen. Based on this graphic, we can put our asset in the risk matrix and evaluate the situation. In this example, the risk manager evaluated the available resources item less risky than team not staffed in time. For the risk evaluation process, there are many strategies: qualitative, based on possible scenarios, quantitative, based on budget. Then we have to define a strategy for each risk to reduce or eliminate or mitigate it. Assumption of the risk: we continue operating doing nothing. Avoid the risk: eliminate the cause by patching, buy new hardware, train people, and so on. Transfer the risk to third-party entities like insurance. Planning, by implementing a plan to manage risk with priorities. Limit the risk by implementing controls to minimize the impact. For example, it's very important to implement an incident handling procedure. This is a schema of an incident handling procedure. That's a formal written procedure to apply when bad things occur. Its scope is to minimize the damage by facing the problem in a systematic approach. It consists in 5 phases: preparation, detection analysis, containment eradication fixing, document the incident, and document the lesson learned. The risk analysis should be regularly updated in order to fit with new assets, new vulnerabilities, new threats. In conclusion, in this lesson, we received some tips on risk management, identification, analysis, evaluation, mitigation, implementing a security incident procedure, ongoing continuous audit to the risk matrix. That's all, thanks and bye bye!